Good morning. Welcome to SmackDown Catfishing. I'm your host today, Stacy Gaston. I'm hoping for an action-packed day. So y'all stay tuned in. We're going to share some tips and techniques. We're on the Alabama River fishing on the Millers Ferry Reservoir today, over here around Camden, Alabama. Just got on the water this morning, and we're out here just trying to spot some fish and find some quality type fish to catch using our electronics. I probably upgraded several years ago, probably 10, to side image. As soon as they come out with side imaging, I got what they call an 0898, is what my first unit was. I got one of them, stuck it on my boat, and I had a really good unit. Didn't know how to use it, but it really looked good on my boat. Made me look like I was a fisherman. Over the years, I've started to use it. And this right here is a Helix 12. I've run a Helix 12, a Helix 9. One of the things that I've done is try to look for fish. And so we're trying to spot fish to make sure this morning as we're fishing that we're going to be fishing on some fish. We've spotted some fish in here. We've done a little bit of looking this morning and seen where some is in here. The further we get up the river, the thicker they get. But I don't like to start right on top of them fish. I always like to find where the fish is at, sort of back off from them, get all my stuff set up, and drag into them. I don't like to just get on top of them, throw my stuff down, and start fishing. I like to get off probably, I'm probably 100 yards from, or maybe a little bit further, maybe 200 or 300 yards from where the thick of them fish was at. I got some electronics. One of the things that I've learned, if you have electronics, it does you no good to go out and buy thousands of dollars of electronics, put them on your boat, and don't use them. They're gonna be useless. One of the things I've done, I spent a lot of money on electronics over the years, and in doing so, I've tried my best to make sure that when I fish, I wanna be fishing on fish. The more confidence, the more I've used my electronics, the more confidence I've got in them, I'm constantly looking for fish before I ever even try to set up. Now there is times and places when I look and I can't find any. I don't know if I just buried down the bottom or what they are. Maybe tied into structure. Then I would just go by eyesight and look for things. But I'm gonna tell you, the more you use your electronics, the more confidence you're gonna be able to put in them. And now I start to rely a lot on my electronics. I use them every day that I come out. I'm constantly looking for fish. When drifting and dragging baits, I'm gonna use my electronics to make sure that my boat stays in position, that we stay on route, and that I stay on top of the fish. Let me see if I can. Here we see some fish in here. We've come over these fish and now we're dragging back through them. I have a 12 set up on my dash. I use it sort of as my sonar, my down imaging and side imaging. And I use this right here. This is a Helix 9. Now this right here is a Lake Master card on here. And when we come through here, these fish were located out in here. Now, I love to fish ledges, so I'm bringing my boat back over here because you can see where this ledge is on this map. And we're going to get over here, and I got some planer boards out, so I don't have to get right on top of this ledge. I'm going to want my boat out here about where this dot's at. And once I come over, here's my boat right here now. Once I bring it over, we're going to just go right up through here and keep it about on that contour. And at the same time, we're going to be watching our sonar to make sure we're still on top of fish as we drag and pull baits up through here. This is what I do. I constantly watch this right here. My boat positioning is critical to me. I'm real particular about this. I want to be in a certain place. I just don't want to be out here just roaming around. I want to be on top of fish while I'm fishing. I think when you start to do this right here, the more you start to practice it, the more confidence you're going to find that you're going to get in your units, learning to trust your sonar, and you're going to find out that your fish rate is going to increase greatly.
If you don't have iPilot Lincoln, maybe you have iPilot. To try to keep your boat on course without working yourself to death, if you have a remote control that has the north up button, I got my control sitting right here, and this right here button is north up. If you would hit it one time, this light is going to come on right there that says north up. You can see it right there, the end with it pointed forward. And what else is going to happen? I don't know if this works on iPilot or just iPilot Link, but here's a purple line. Y'all see that line right there? And as I move my control, I'm gonna sit right here and pop it over just a little bit. And when I do, watch my line, I'm bringing it over. Now that line right there, that purple line is going to be the projected course in which my boat is going to follow. Now it's gonna follow it right on up to there. And if I want to move it over just a little bit, all I got to do is move my left or right button just a touch, and you're gonna see it. You see how that moved? And there's now my projected course. And it'll stay on that course until I move it again. I wanna carry it right in yonder towards that little knob right there. And once we get close to it, we're gonna come right around it and just keep going right up beside this channel right here. Maybe that'll help you out.
I think we got our first fish on today. Yep. Oh, he just come off too. Well, that's two we done missed. We done missed two of them sapsuckers. Them son of guns is putting it on us this morning. Look at them, they're bait thieves. Joker done stole my bait. It's all right. We will get even. All right, we hooked up with the first fish of the day. Feels good to get one on. Oh, talk to me. Y'all listen to him. We had him hair-lipped. That's what my daddy used to call it. You got him hair-lipped. Well, first one of the day. You know, we had a bunch of them trying to steal our bait today. But as we getting a little bit of slime on the boat, maybe this is the beginning of a good day. Catching fish on purpose. Oh, probably about the same size as the rest of them. There we go. I'm gonna give you an idea so you'll know about how much these fish weigh. That one right there is about 6 pounds. Pretty good fish. All right, wait. Got us another one on, Daddy. I want y'all to look at this one. There we go. Just a good little catfish. Somewhere between a 9.5, 10 pounds. Go back down to the deep. And he just tore out. He nailed that planer board. Pretty decent fish. Cut up, boy, cut up. That mad catter's got him. I can tell you that. Now these BOGO grips have got him. All right. Hold on, Betsy. There's another one for the day. Let me back it up here. I'm gonna give you a weight on him. Around here. He's 14 pounds. Good fish. We marking these fish. Get in here and found where they at. And we just drifting through them, dragging baits through them. And catching them. We ain't fishing by accident. We're trying to fish and catch them on purpose. spotting them on our graph. Know there's some fish in here, and just dragging baits through them. Oh, we got another one, guys. Got us another little kitty cat, hopefully. There's another one. I'm gonna be careful with him. One of them finned me the other day. Guys, thank y'all for staying tuned in with us today. Hope the things that we have shared on this channel has been helpful to you. I want to encourage you, if you have got some electronics and you're trying to get used to them, I know you could probably ask me 101 questions and go to your local dealer who deals with Hummingbird or whatever electronics you have chosen. And they can probably ask and you can answer the questions, this and another. But I'm going to tell you the number one thing that you cannot replace: time on the water and just sort of checking your unit out, trial and error. A lot of people ask, what does catfish look like? What does this look like? Well, once you spotted some fish, start trying to anchor up and fish on them. The way that I found out what was catfish and what was other fish is I would start seeing fish gathered together and really didn't have a clue what they were. I thought maybe they was catfish. So I would pull up, fish on them. I would start catching catfish. Then I started making a connection that this is what they look like. On the reservoir here where I'm at, I'm on the Alabama River at Miller's Ferry. We really don't have but a couple more fish that sort of is out here where these catfish will be at, and that's spoonbill and gar. And I've learned to identify them. Most of the time, if you see some arches that's on the bottom, that's gonna have red sort of closer to the front of it, and this may sort of fade out as it comes to the rear. That right there is probably a catfish. If you look at something that's high up in the water column, it's probably more like gar. If you have down imaging and side imaging, you can flip over to them. And if you're sort of going maybe under a mile per hour, you can start trying to tune in and see exactly what kind of fish them are. One of my biggest mistakes, and one of the things I wanted to sort of really enforce today, is make it a habit of fishing on fish. For years, I had no electronics. And when I did have it, I didn't put no trust in it. I just went back and done the same old thing that I've always done. I'd go to the same old holes all the time. Sometimes we would catch them, sometimes we didn't. Sometimes we would catch big ones, sometimes we wouldn't. And that's what a lot of people do when they start out catfishing. They have, over time, they have discovered a couple good places to go fish. And there's nothing wrong with that. The thing, though, that I discovered, I was going back to these same places and not catching anything. I would even go over these holes with my electronics and wouldn't see anything there. Yet I would pull up, anchor down, and sit there for 2 or 3 hours and not catch nothing. And I would do it time and time again because we have our memory tells us, hey, we've caught fish here before. We just got to wait for them to bite. One of the things I have discovered by studying catfish and by putting a lot of time on the water, these fish are moving. They're moving up and down on ledges. They're not at the same depth all the time. You may catch them here today. They may be a little bit further down that column on that ledge tomorrow. They might have moved from the deep water up into the shallow. They might have moved from the shallow back to the deep. And so, if you'll start to just take time on the water, one of the things that I've done, I think probably the most helpful thing, I would come over here to the river fishing right by myself, and I would say, today, if I don't see fish, I'm not fishing. And I spent time starting to look for them. And I would go through them and see where I would find several fish. And I'm not just looking for one. I'm looking for where I see a several arches in a spot or in a span. That's what I'm looking for. And so when I started seeing that, I said, I'm gonna fish here. I started catching fish. And so once you do that, you start to build confidence in your electronics. You start to build confidence in what you're doing. I'm going to tell you, it's a lot of trial and error, but I promise you, put the time in on the water. Practice. Don't be scared to try something different. Don't be scared to try different techniques. Don't be scared to try to deal with your unit. Get it set. Get it set where you're comfortable with it. Look for arches. Use your sensitivity. Use your contrast. Use your sonar. Use your DI. If you're in shallow waters where I use my side imaging at, don't be afraid to try that. You've got a lot of money invested in these units. The only way that you are going to be able to use them and feel successful with them and feel confident with them is you just start to use them. I can tell you 100 times, but until you start to go out, spot fish, and catch fish on them, your confidence is probably going to stay at zero. But once you start doing this, I'm telling you, your catch rate is going to start to increase. Your consistency is going to start to increase. And I'm telling you, you're going to be smackdown ready. Thank you for tuning in with us. Continue to follow us here on YouTube. If you like our channel, subscribe to it. Share this right here on Facebook, if you will. I thank everyone for your time, for your patience, and for your support that you have given us here at Smackdown Catfishing. I'm Stacy Gasson. You can find me on Facebook under that. You can also find me under Facebook on Smackdown Catfishing there also. God bless you. Have a great day. And remember, Jesus is Lord.